Children, today we are going to discuss about Lagrange mean value theorem. First, we have studied about Rolle's mean value theorem, and today we are going to study Lagrange mean value theorem. Let's try to understand what the theorem is and how to apply this theorem, how to see that whether the mean value theorem exists or not. Let's see this curve. You can see, children, this curve. In this curve, there are two points A and B. And this curve is a continuous curve. It does not break at any point. Okay. And if we join this chord AB, then you can see this chord is parallel to this tangent. So this Lagrange mean value theorem says that there must exist between A and B at least one point at which, if a tangent is drawn, that tangent will be parallel to the given chord, the chord AB, right? Let's read the theorem. Lagrange mean value theorem asserts that there is at least one point lying between A and B such that the tangent at which is parallel to the chord AB. Or there may exist more than one point. See, here in this diagram, there are more than one point. There are three points at which the tangent is parallel to the given chord AB. Right? The chord of AB. So there are three points where the tangent is parallel to the chord. Right, children? Note down this much first. Now, children, the condition to verify that for the Lagrange mean value theorem, that it whether it is applicable or not. So first condition is a function must be continuous in the closed interval a comma b. So this square bracket represents the closed interval a comma b. That means the function must be continuous. It should not be discontinuous. If at, in between a and b, if it's become discontinuous, that means if you cannot draw a tangent at that point, right? It will not hold any value at that point, right? So first condition, the function must be continuous in the closed interval a comma b. That means between a and b, all points will be defined. Okay, in between all the points at between A and B, all the images will be defined, right? And second is the function is derivable in the open interval A comma B. That means the derivative at every point between A and B must exist, right, children? Only these are the two conditions to find that Lagrange mean value theorem is applicable. So when these two points are true, then we can say that the function is continuous in closed interval and derivable in open interval. Then we say that Lagrange mean value theorem is applicable. So when we find that it is applicable, then we can say that there must exist at least one point at which a tangent is drawn is parallel to the chord. So if the slope of the chord, when you calculate, you will get FB minus FA upon B minus A. y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1, and f dash c is the slope of the tangent at point C. Suppose this is a point C, so this is the slope of the tangent at of the curve, right? So this slope of the tangent and this slope of the chord will be equal. So from here we can say that the value of f dash c will be fb minus fa upon b minus a, right, children? Note down. Let's try to understand the topic by discussing the sum, children. In this question, it is given that verify Lagrange mean value theorem and find C. That means the first you have to verify, and second we have to calculate that point at which the tangent is parallel to the given chord, right? And the function is given as fx equals to x square minus 2x plus 4, and the interval is given is 1 comma 5. In the closed interval 1 comma 5. Let's do the solution, children. First condition, you can see that fx is a polynomial, so every polynomial is a continuous function. So we can say that when fx is a polynomial, so fx is continuous in the closed interval 1 comma 5, right, children? In the closed interval 1 comma 5. And second condition, you can say that it's a polynomial, it is continuous, and polynomial is derivable also. So we can say that fx is derivable in the open interval 1 comma 5. That means the derivative of the function exists in this interval. There is no point at which the derivative, that means f dash x, is not defined right? At every point between 1 comma 5, f dash x is defined, right children? So both the conditions are verified, so we can say that Lagrange mean value theorem is verified. Now let's find the point C. So if you calculate fb, that is f5, it will be 5 square minus 2 into 5 plus 4, that will be 25 minus 10 plus 4, it will be 19. And if you calculate fa, that is 1, a is 1, f1, it will be 1 square minus 2 into 1 plus 4. So you can see that 1 plus 4, 5 minus 2, it is 3. So fb is 19, at 5 is 19, f1 is 3. And we know that f dash x is 2x minus 2. So f dash c will be 2c minus 2, right children? So this 2c minus 2 will be f5 minus f1 upon 5 minus 1. So when we put the values of f5, f1 and b and a, we'll get 19 minus 3 upon 4. So 2c minus 2 equals to 16 by 4 equals to 4. When you transfer this to that side, you'll get 2c equals to 6. So the value of c will be 3. That means at 3, x equals to 3, when a tangent is drawn, that tangent will be parallel to the given chord. Right children? Note down please. Let's discuss another sum children. In this sum, the question says verify Lagrange mean value theorem and find c. Again, we have to find the point c and verify the theorem. Function is given as fx equals to x minus 2 sin x, and the interval that is given to us is minus pi to pi, right? We know that x is an algebraic function, or rather a polynomial function, and polynomial is a continuous function, so we can say that x is continuous, and sin x is defined for all values of x. That means the domain of sin x is all real numbers. That means in between all the values minus pi to pi, sin x exists. So we can say that the sin x is also a continuous function. So from x and sin x, we can say that hence fx is continuous in the closed interval minus pi to pi. All right, children. That means the function is continuous, we have shown. Now let's see the differentiability. If we differentiate the function f dash x equals to what will come? Dy dx of x, 1. And dy dx of sin x is cos x, okay, and cos x, that derivative of cos x exists, so we can say that fx is differentiable in open interval minus pi to pi, right? There is no point between minus pi to pi at which cos x is not defined. So we say that cos x is differentiable, derivable in between the interval minus pi to pi. So if we calculate the value of f of minus pi, you put x equals to minus pi, so it will be minus pi minus 2 sine minus pi. So it will be minus pi plus sine of minus theta minus sine theta, so this minus minus will be plus, minus pi plus 2 sine pi. That will be sine pi is 0, right? So only minus pi will come. So f of minus pi will be minus pi. If we calculate the value of f pi, so it will be pi minus 2 sin pi. Again, sin pi is 0. F pi will be only pi. Now, the formula that we have, when we compare the slopes, it is f dash c equals to fb minus fa upon b minus a. Right, children? F dash c equals to fb minus fa upon b minus a. So f dash c, the value of f dash c is 1 minus 2 cos c. And fb is pi. And fa is minus pi. So pi minus of minus pi, it will be pi plus pi. Again, pi minus of minus pi, it will be pi plus pi. So 2 pi upon 2 pi will be 1. Right? And this one will get cancelled. Right, children? This one and this one will get cancelled. If you will get 0. So minus 2 cos c equals 0. So cos c equals to 0. And the value of 0 is... In between this interval, you will get two zeros, two values of zeros at cos 90 degree and cos minus 90 pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 and cos minus pi by 2. So in place of this 0, we can write cos plus minus pi by 2. Right? So when we compare the angle, we'll get value of c as plus minus pi by 2. Right, children? Note down, please. Children, let's see another sum of the exercise. In this sum, it is given that verify Lagrange mean value theorem, find c. Same thing we have to do. But the function is given as fx equals to x minus 1 to the power 2 by 3. And the interval is given close interval 1 comma 2. Right. Let's first check the conditions of the Lagrange mean value theorem. First, the function must be continuous. Second, the function must be derivable. Continuity in closed interval and differentiability in open interval. Right. Let's start solving. X minus 1, if we see that at 1 it will be 0 and at 2 it will be 1, and in between 1 and 2 all the points the function is defined. There is no point at which the function is not defined, so we can say that fx is continuous in the closed interval 1 comma 2. In the closed interval 1 comma 2. Alright children. Now when we calculate, when we find the derivative of fx, f dash fx, that will be f dash x, it will be 2 by 3 x minus 1 to the power 2 by 3 minus 1, it will be minus 1 by 3. So when this power become positive, the term will go into denominator, so it will be 2 by 3 x minus 1 to the power 1 by 3. Right children, now you can see that if x equals to 1, then x minus 1 will become 0, so 2 upon 0 will be not defined. So we can say that only at 1 it will be 0. So that means it is defined, f dash x is differentiable in the open interval. Right children? In the open interval 1 comma 2. Right? So in one open interval, in between all the values of 1 comma 2 interval, f dash x is defined. There is no point at which f dash x does not exist. Right children? So that means we can say that fx is derivable or differentiable in the open interval 1 comma 2. Alright, let's find the value of fb and fa, or f2 or f1. F2 will be 2 minus 1 to the power 2 by 3. So 2 minus 1, 1 to the power 2 by 3 is 1. F1 will be 1 minus 1 to the power 2 by 3. So it will be 0. Right? So f dash c will be 2 by 3 into c minus 1 to the power 1 by 3 equals to fb minus fa upon b minus a. That is 1 minus 0 upon 2 minus 1. It will be 1, right? So when we cross multiply this term, it will be c minus 1 to the power 1 by 3 equals to 2 by 3. So when we do the cube of both the sides, you'll get c minus 1 here, and 2 by 3 cube will be 8 by 27. Transfer one that side, you'll get the value of c, 1 plus 8 by 7, it will be 35 upon 27. All right, children. Understood Lagrange mean value theorem? So we have discussed most of the sums from the exercise. I hope you have understood. Try to solve all the sums in your favorite notebooks.